Don't do that. I know you get out with your friends, you have a good time, especially fellas, you know, to play that game, play the fight game, you know. You know, you fight around your fellas and it's funny. Dudes be doing that. They be getting in elevators and fighting and laughing and shit. It's nasty. You play the fight game. I think deep down inside, people want to smell other people's fights. Because you smell them. And people always tell you they fighted. They say, I fought it. You don't leave. You pause a second. Yeah, you did. Because in the back of your mind, you want to grade the fight. But if it smelled bad enough, 2 years later, you'd be going, remember that fight you made 2 years ago? The fight game you play. Start off around the house when you're little. Your father introduced you to it. You'd be sitting in the house one day, it was Saturday morning, watching cartoons, your father make a fight and go, that wasn't me, that was your mother. That was your mother, that was, ooh, baby, baby, I want a divorce, baby. Ooh, you rotten, baby, shit. Your mother goes, stop, and you join in and shit. You grab your little brother, sit on his head and fight, never do that? That's a fun game. Your little brother freak out and go, hey, that is funny. Your father goes, it's the fight game. You'll play one day, son. The fight game. You get your best friend in on that shit, too. You can walk up to your best friend while he's watching a football game and fighting this face. He won't even get mad. He just go, okay, you got me. All right. Okay. All right. That was a good one, too. My mouth was open. My mouth was open. I got a scar over my eye to this day from playing the fight game in the bathtub when I was little. Me and my big brother used to play it. We was poor, we didn't have no Mr. Bubble, we played the fight game. We'd be in that tub, that bloop. Bloop. Bloop.
You can smell it, you can smell it.
Ever hold your G.I. Joe over it, guys? We're going, din-din-din-din-din-din-din-din-din-din-din-din.
And G.I. Joe is swimming underwater. Dun 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 dun. And G.I. Joe want to find out where the bubbles is coming from. Dinning on the bottom of the ocean. So he started to venture into the cave from whence they came. Din din din. And G.I. Joe got stuck, and G.I. Joe got stuck in the water.
And my big brother was sitting in the other end of the tub and shit, and made a shit in the tub. He wanted to add some excitement to the game and shit, because he took, I was going, G.I. Joe, then he said,
and then a big brown shark came.
I jumped up and said, ah!
Cut my eye in a soap dish and blood was gushing out my face and shit. Screaming, mother ran in the bathroom. See my big brother sitting in the bathroom with a piece of shit in his hand in the tub. I was laying in the bottom of the water with blood gushing out my eye. And G.I. Joe up my ass.
Mother, what the fuck's going on in there? Ooh, you know what would be a good, can I hold somebody's camera? Anybody bring a camera? You look, does it flash go immediately? Like I don't have to be waiting like my aunt and shit going, wait a second now. Ever do that, you be posing your ass off like this and your aunt be going, wait, it's the flash. Then try to press it and the shit don't work, to be going,
it's something wrong with us.
It'll go immediately, the flash. You sure? I'll take a picture of the crowd for myself. Can all y'all come over here on this side? No? I take two of them. This ain't no Instamatic motherfucker. I got to wait for the flash and shit. See, you got me waiting. I should break your shit. There's a brother sitting in the back going, all this money, he taking motherfucking pictures. I want my picture took, I steal a car, motherfucker.
Hey, man, I said one fucking picture. You're using up all my fucking film, man. Come on, shit! Who the fuck do you think you are, man?
Let's see, explain the last one to the guys at Photo Map.
That's a picture of Eddie Murphy's dick.
Ooh, you know what'd be a good picture? Can all the brothers stand up? All the brothers in the audience? Straight up. Everybody up. All the brothers. Up. Straight up. I'm serious. What the fuck you're doing? Will you motherfuckers stand up? Up. And all the ladies, get your cameras out. We're gonna set the record straight here. When I say go, everybody whip out their dick and go, ah! Sat down. Sat down quick. Listen, hey. Some of them still standing. Y'all must be Italian. They know about the motherfucking, we got some shit on us. We got all this shit. We the shaboinking people. We got some dicks hanging down. Dicks down to this motherfucker. Y'all don't believe it. White people don't believe it. What's funny about it is white people are the ones that made up the rumor. It's like they said, you know, black people have tremendous dicks. But I don't believe it. Now we the dick, you know, remains of the first dick was found in Africa? A big ass piece of bone dick on the floor. What is this shit? It's an old dried up dick. That means the first dick belonged to a black man.
Dicks. We got the shit, boy. We got nice asses, too. We got our shit all hooked. See my ass?
I see a white dude be up in his suit like this.
How are ya? What's happening? Hey. Man. All right, man. All right, man. Right on, man.
I got a friend, Doug. There go Doug, my friend. Doug's ass is way up here on his back. Ain't it, Doug? Doug be getting shit stains on his collar and shit.
And be in restaurants, be reaching for his wallet, say, let me get my wallet.
Because we got our shit hooked. We got all this shit is hooked up with black people. Chinese people fucked all around because they got little dicks and little asses. They do, and it fucked up the way they walk. They be walking all light because they ain't got no shit pulling them down. Now, brother's dick is too big, so it fucked up his balance. He be doing all this shit. Every time you see a brother in a wheelchair, he ain't always crippled. You got this shit hanging down. That's why I don't let brothers model their drawers in a newspaper. Think about it. I've been seeing newspapers every Sunday morning, white dudes being there in their drawers like this. Never have no bulge in their drawers. Smiling at you. If I ain't have no bulge, I wouldn't be smiling at you. Be modeling like this. These dudes are going, I don't have any dick. Brother be standing there. If a brother model his drawers in the paper, they need an extra fold out in the paper.
There's a sale on underwear, but this nigger sticks in my coffee.
Want me to stir it for you?
That's some true shit. What's today's date? It's the 17th and shit. They got a little bit more summer and shit. Don't go to cookouts. I hate cookouts, man. Stay away from cookouts and shit. If you like me, you stay the fuck away from cookouts. I don't like my family come by the house. The relatives I ain't seen like since the last cookout. You got certain relatives you just see at the cookout. And they get on your fucking nerves every year. My Uncle Gus come by the house every year. My Uncle Gus is the uncle that like to work the grill and don't let nobody touch the grill when he's around and shit. As soon as he walk in the house, he's like, get away from that grill. You don't know how to start no fire. You know how to start no fire. Put this fire out. This ain't no fire, goddammit. Eddie, go over there and give me all that wood. I need half a tree. Chop that tree down over there. Chop down that tree and give me the wood from that tree over there. And Charlie, go give me 2 gallons of gasoline out of the shed.
You 2 gallons of gasoline, you kids roll up your shirt, put that on the grill. We're gonna start a fire. Come on, you wanna eat? You wanna eat? Then shut up, then put that on the fire. Okay, put that wood inside there. Okay, give me the gasoline, Charlie. Hold the match. Well, I tell you, Charlie, throw the match on the gasoline, all right? Well, I tell you, all right, we're gonna make a fire. We're gonna eat it, right? Y'all wanna eat? We're gonna eat now. Here we go. Pour the gasoline on here like this. There. We need the whole get that goddamn lighter fluid out there. That can't use this shit. We're gonna put all 2 gallons of gasoline on this wood and make a fire. We're gonna eat a hamburger, okay? Here we go. Charlie, throw the match. Now that's a fire. That's a fire. Look at that. Look at that. He be all right. Roll Charlie around. Roll him around a little bit. Roll him around.
And Uncle Gus is married to my Aunt Bunny. My Aunt Bunny got a mustache and shit. You know, one of them lady mustaches. It was real cool back when she was 20. She had, you know, ladies had them little thin ones and shit. Then when they get about 45, like Aunt Bunny, they be having the Billy Dee Williams look. Shit be thicker than a man's and shit. Aunt Bunny weighed like 300 pounds, like 250, real heavy lady and shit, and the kids were scared of her. You got that kid logic going. I remember my Aunt Bunny come by the house and shit. It was like, I was petrified because she always wanted to kiss me or touch me and some shit. As soon as she walked in the door, it's like, come give your Aunt Bunny a kiss, baby.
And you go, mother say, why don't you want to kiss your Aunt Bunny? Kids don't give a fuck. They go,
she got a mustache.
Why do kids move so slow when they be crying? Stop making all that noise. I said shut up. You be mad because your mother hits you. You be standing there wishing hateful shit on your mother. Ever do that? Be in the bedroom going,
God, please kill her. I hope she get hit by a truck and die. I hate her.
Shut up, I'm coming to give something to cry about.